Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we will do a fine tuning of a LAMA2 7 billion parameters model using a specialized dataset in ChainOthru. We will use the technique QLORA, and this is an exercise that I already did in the past, but at that time I use a Mistral 7 billions. This model that I use in the previous video, this all the information you have it already on the channel, and also the notebooks in the repository. You have here the same exercise, but at that time I did it with a Mistral 7 billions, and then on the purpose of the exercise of today is just compare the outputs of the two models. Both models are going to be fine or were fine tuned with the COT dataset, with the KAIS AI COT collection, and then we will compare at the end of the exercise the output. The same questions I did, I asked to the Mistral 7 billion fine tuned, I will do with the LAMA2 fine tuned as well. So we go to the notebook. It's practically a repetition of the exercise I did. The only thing that changed is the model. This case, in the case of Mistral, it was a model that was previously fine tuned for multiple tags. Then on I specialize in COT, and in this case I take the LAMA2 7 billions. It is a foundational model, so we are slightly a step back in comparison with the Mistral 7 billion instruct version 2, and then you will see in the outputs that is there is a difference as well on the answer that the model after fine tuning is providing. So for those who are not familiar with ChainOthru, this is a technique of prompt engineering, which essentially claim to overperform zero shot and few shot prompting. And essentially what we are doing in this technique is giving an example of the reasoning to the model, and to help is like kind of context to help the model to solve the reasoning tags. As you may know, COT, this reasoning tags, is one of the most difficult tags from large LLMs. They use not to perform very well doing this kind of solving this kind of tags. And especially models with such size, which even when you may know that they are big models with 7 million, they are very small in terms of the ability to build or to answer correctly these kind of questions. Models, bigger models, obviously, with more parameters like ChatGPT or GPT-4 or Gemini, they are more capable, but even those models, which had some of them trillions of parameters, are unable of answer correctly these questions. I make some tests as well. Some of the questions you will see here in this notebook, I did it with GPT 3.5 Turbo, even Gemini, and or GPT-4, and even those models fails on that questions. This is a topic that is is a hot topic today. COT and prompt engineering. There is multiple research ongoing in how to improve the abilities of reasoning of the language like large language models. And well, every day there is new discoveries. There is I upload some of the videos where I speak about the techniques of prompt engineering, the techniques how to handle memory in LLMs and some others. Yes, and the thing I want to tell you is there is a lot of the in research around the topic, because it's one of the attacks that COT that is not correctly solve, or most of the questions are not correctly solved by LLMs. No? I give you the same. This is already included on the Mistral notebook, but we can go through briefly, just describing the. This is the paper which describes the COT prompting, and some of the links which I found interesting that you can go through, explaining or giving you examples of how it's going. The Zero-Shot COT prompting chain of through paper. So and some other examples we told you will give you an insight of the limitations, especially when you are working with the models in this size, 7 billion, 13 billion. There are models which perform very good in for summarization, for example, classification, but here still there are a couple of step backs and plenty, we have plenty of room to improve these models, and also with new techniques and new research that can help to improve the abilities of these models. Also, to don't create too much expectation of what is possible to do with this model, even Llama 2 or Mistral, even fine-tuning the models with an specialized data set, like is the case I'm going to show you here, is improving the output, but not getting in any case an excellent or performance or even solving tags. That what I said, no? even models with a bigger number of parameters are not able to solve. So the objective again, I wanted to compare these two models, because as you may know as well, Mistral claims to overperform Llama 2 7 billion and Llama 13b 7 billion in some tags, but in these tags Mistral 7 billion overperform here Llama 2 7 billion, but I consider that is because the training was done with Cullora, and probably you know that the original weights in Cullora training are not changed, and then I use a Mistral 7B Instruct version 2, which was already fine-tuned for multiple tags, is somehow more advanced in terms of the reason, chain of through reasoning, than the Llama 2 7 billion foundation model. So in this case, the weights that had Llama 2, I will say that are less prepared to answer these questions that the model, that the weights of the model Mistral 7B Instruct version 2. You had all the details on the links, and you can go to the repository and look at the experiments I did with Mistral and do your own comparisons. The dataset is this COT collection from Kais AI, and this dataset was prepared to create this paper, this research paper, and then it's a 1.84 million of samples of COT grouped in 1,060 different tags, all of them connected with reasoning, and all these samples come from multiple datasets. You had you can go through the paper and understand in detail how the dataset was created. You can go as well to the Hugging Face and take a look. The kind of questions and examples that you have in the dataset, toxic classification, science, natural language question answering, arithmetic program execution. So it's quite extensive. And then you can also take a look to the some examples even on the page and take a grasp. We will see one here on the notebook anyway. So we install the libraries we need, we import the same locale for Google Colab, our task to create the projecting weight and biases as usual. By the way, I need a Colab Pro as usual using A100. Is in a T4 is unfortunately is not working. Here we create the bits and bytes configuration for NF4 quantization. You have also here a link about this new data type, which is reducing is the type that the reduce maximum reduction in memory footprint. We load the model with this quantization. Here you had the memory footprint is around is 38 megabytes or not three gigabytes of memory. So now we load the tokenizer, we download the model, we just make some cleaning, we prepare the prompt. Yes, here I use exactly the same prompt that I use for the Mistral 7B, to be fair. I just change slightly the prompt to adapt it to Llama 2. You have here an example, it's a random example of the one of the rows in our dataset. Here we map in we create the prompts into the dataset, and we remove here the non-necessary columns. Here on the text attributes of our dataset, we had the prompt in text, and here the model configuration, we had a 4096 size of the Windows context, max length, we get it here. Length of the dataset, here we do the tokenization of our dataset. We will have the tokenized version of the prompt into this field. This is the field or the attribute that is expecting the trainer as input. And here we are just getting the heads that are being quantized in 4 bits. We take the names of the attention heads, they are exactly the same in terms of name that the Mistral, but in different order. Here this link I send you is a very very good discussion about the parameters, QLORA parameters, the ranking and the LoRa alpha. This is a discussion. Even after reading the paper, the QLORA paper, or some of the some brilliant articles I found in internet regarding the topic, there is no consensus in how to better configure it. At least I didn't get still how to correctly configure the ranking and LoRa alpha, what are the optimal, because you can read on the paper, they make a configuration for the models that they were including on the research paper, but then on how to adapt this research to the new techniques that are applied in models like Llama or Mistral, this is still a question. At least to be honest, I still didn't get how to do it correctly. So what I decided is to compare correctly the both experiments. I use the same. So I saw some examples of other people who is doing similar experiments with other dataset. They put the ranking to 64 for Llama 2 and LoRa Alpha 16, and they apply the quantization, the QLoRA to all the attention heads. I here doing exactly the same that I did on the other experiment. So you see here I just taking 4 of the 7 head attentions which are quantized, and then just to repeat the same experiment that we did. As I said before, it's not exactly the same experiment because the models' weights in the case of Mistral in my opinion, have better quality because they are already fine-tuned with for multiple tasks, something that is not happening with the ways of the our Llama 2 7 videos that I'm using here on this experiment. Here we get the model with the quantized model with the LoRa configuration. We check here the percentage of trainable parameters. As you may know, what we are going to train here is only the matrix, the ranking matrix is the only thing that we are going to train during this experiment, and you will see afterwards why some of the papers I described you on the top of this on the notebook well got a conclusion. So we are not changing the weights of the original model, in this case the Llama 2 7 billion, in the other case the Mistral 7 billion since 2p2. We are just simply training the models the weights of the ranking matrices, and in this case you will see the difference, no? Why training only that a small percentage of the parameters, yeah, improve the abilities of the model, but we are starting from different points, no? In the case of Mistral, I think it's a little bit advanced in terms of the how to say, abilities of the answer this kind of questions. In the case of Llama 2, is a little bit back. No, you will see later on looking at the answer and comparing the answer of the two models. No, we are here prepare the trainer. It's exactly the same parameters that we train the model with the same number of steps. Same configuration, same learning rate, etc. Exactly the same that we did with the 7B, Mistral 7B. We push the model to Hugging Face. It's up to you. You want to publish for the public. Here we just save the model to local. Now we save the model to weight and biases for later use if you want to. Here I tried to load the original model and come on. Okay. To make comparison as well in between the fine-tuned model and the Llama 2 model, but I don't have the memory enough to run both models in GPU, so I decided to just comment the original model configuration. Here I just get the model from Hugging Face, the model I previously pushed to the hub. The config of this model is exactly the same model as I fine-tuned, just I wanted to get the model that I pushed there. This is the memory footprint. If you see here, this model is slightly bigger than the original model. That's this why it's because we are merging here the original weights with the QLoRa weights that we fine-tuned. And then that's why the size is slightly. You look at the size that we have here. Let me find. Okay. Plants. So we have here 3.84. Below is 3.90 something, if I don't remember wrong. Let me check. Okay, 3.91. This is the output of merging the original model with the QLoRa weights that we train in this fine tuning. Now I test. I make some the same questions that I did in the Mistral notebook. So I provide a list of the elements, and I ask the model to give me the sum of the numbers. In this case, it's pretty simple, 849. But you will see that the model is answering wrong. is not answering correctly. Here we do the same experiment as well. It's a mathematical exercise, very simple logic. I bought an apple, so I gave two to the neighbor, two to the repairman, and they both fight, and I ate one. So I had 10, finally. So, but the model also fails here, and probably 7. Here, I was 6. When I was 6, my sister was half of my age. I'm now 70. What is the age of my sister? Answer is 67. The model also fails. Here, I had a car 20 years ago, and at that time I was 37. How old I am? Here, pretty simple, 57. Yeah, it is answering correctly, and this, well, this also failed. This example failed even GPT-4. So I was not surprised when it fails. No? Read this instruction. Okay, I had a car 20 years ago and it cost $100,000. Car annual depreciation is 5% using the percent declining balance method. What is the value of the car? This, well, is complicated, but well, it's something that you probably learn during the high school. But well, it's not a really complicated problem. And then, well, the model essentially fails as well. It's providing a wrong answer. Mistral also did a wrong answer, and I also include here the magic Lechstein step by step, and the model also answer wrongly. So, yeah. We can take a look to the answers that provide Mistral with the same to the same answers. Let's go back here. So the question of the list, we had 809 Mistral answer it correctly. 10 apples. The problem of the apples is also correctly answered and also provide a very long explanation, Mistral. So here the age problem, the age of my sister, 60 years old, the model is answering correctly. Yeah, the my age, when I had a car 20 years ago, blah blah blah, 50 years old now, and then explaining as well. Yeah, and here the problem with the car depreciation is wrong. But somehow it's closer, but yeah, in any case it's wrong. So it's doing more sophisticated calculations, Mistral, but well, again, it's giving us a wrong answer in here as well. So the answer is 35,849. Here somehow is close, but not getting the right value. So you can see the difference, but in my opinion, as I said, this difference is because we are using two models which are, how to say, had different abilities. Obviously, Llama 2 7B was trained with for multiple tasks as well, but it was not fine-tuned like it was the Instruct version 2, Mistral 7B Instruct version 2, which later on, even when we fine tuning with QLORA, as we are not touching the original models of those two, we are just creating a new matrices that later are joined to the or merged with the original models. This make an impact, an effect on the Mistral 7B, which, well, as you see, is answering better than the Llama 2 7 billions. And that's all. I hope I also make an experiment with the Code Llama. Code Llama is a version of the Llama 2 which is specializing in understanding the programming code. And well, I thought that probably this model is more ready to say something, to answer these kind of questions. The output you have in there is exactly similar to what we got with the conventional Llama 2.7 billions. And that's all. I hope that you like it. I will upload now. Well, you have it already on the repository. I will give you the links on the description of the video, and I hope that you like it again. And if you like it, as I say every time, give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much. See you soon.